Alright, so we're ready to roll? Alright. Oh, we're rolling now. Been flying the drone a lot. Well, not this drone. Actually, I have been flying this drone. Link in the description. This thing is adorable, by the way. No camera, but it's like 20 bucks. A lot of fun. Anyway, been flying this drone a lot. I'm gonna pose for a thumbnail. Would it matter if I shared with you my FAA registered number? I don't know. Just in case, we'll hold it up this way. Again, thumbnail. What a dork. One more. And the AC's on. I know I've been talking a lot about the drones lately, but I've been having a lot of fun. Incidentally, I'll put another link in the description for a really cool place I found to get little stickers for your drone, because you're supposed to have your drone marked with your FAA registration number, whether it's a hobbyist drone or a professional drone. And anyway, this is a kind of a cool way to do it instead of using a Sharpie and some sort of a silly marker. It's a great little, I type my stuff in 2 days later, I had it all printed out, my phone number, all kind of stuff in there. So I highly recommend that. Anyway, link in the description. So what am I going to talk about? Obviously, we're going to talk about drones, but I think what I want to narrow in on today, and I was inspired by another channel, which I'm going to share at the very end of this. It's rare I start one of these and actually have a channel of the week, but he's inspired me to do this. So I want to talk about 5 different types of drone video maneuvers, if you would. I just edited a video, again, link in the description. It's a Vimeo upload. Some drone footage I did down by the Intercoastal, and I realized as I watched this other person's video that I was doing some of these kind of camera moves on my own, a couple of other ones he didn't mention. So I want to talk about 5 really cool drone camera maneuver, well, whatever it's going to be. I'll name it later. Let's get started. I started this video with one film, we'll call them film maneuvers. I'm going to call this the takeoff reveal. And what I'm going to do is after I talk about these, I'll show you what kind of move I'm talking about. But let me just describe briefly what each one of these is. The first one, like I said, the takeoff reveal. I was taking off with the drone. I simulated a takeoff of the drone flying across the water, and then it lifted up, and as it lifted up, kind of like a real plane would do, it revealed there were some islands in the foreground, a little bit of a reflection of the sunset and or sunrise, and then there was the other island. There was like an island, then water, then another, whatever. I'll show you what it is. It's the takeoff reveal technique, we'll call it. This is what that looks like. And the second one is a reveal also, I guess you could call it that. So there's 2 ways to do this. One was kind of like, and this was what he was talking about in his, again, this channel that I'm going to share at the end. But this was something I realized I was doing before I actually watched his video. And that is the pan up reveal, meaning you have your gimbal pointed down and you're kind of like maybe at a 45 degree angle. And as you pan up, you're revealing something. Could also be done in reverse. You're up top and you pan down to something below, or you're maybe flying over something and you fly backwards and you reveal something in the foreground. So you're like unfolding a scene, revealing a scene, the reveal technique. Anyway, this is an example of what that looks like. Tend to use this one a lot. I try to not overuse it, but it's really kind of pointing the camera straight down, aligning with something and really getting a bird's eye view, but it's really just the camera straight down overhead technique. And this is an example of what that looks like from the drone. Now, this is another example of something I was using, but I didn't realize what I was doing, and that is kind of similar to what a dolly does. A dolly is one of those things that, I remember this guy Brock, I used to do these events where he'd be back there, and he had these two handles here, there was some counterweights, a big long arm, camera at the end of the arm, and the camera would move, and it was like a dolly shot. Usually straight up, kind of pans. There's a lot of ways to do that with the drone. Again, you don't have a team out there, you don't have a dolly, but you do have the dolly effect that you can create with the drone. And this is a really simple example of what that looks like. So the fifth and final technique I want to talk about today is kind of like, I think it's the parallax effect. And that is when you say you have your camera here and you have something you're filming that's here and in the background, and as you go past this or around this thing in the front, the background tends to move at a different speed than the front. So you have this, this physics thing happening, if you would. This next clip I'm going to show you, there was a really tall building they had just, they're just finishing behind the pink building that's in the front, and as I go around and reveal the building in the back, you'll see that things are moving at a different speed. Again, that's the parallax effect. I really like this. I don't want to overuse it, but it's certainly something to throw into the toolbox, another camera technique to use with a drone, and this is what that looks like. Okay, so as we take this one in for a landing, pardon the pun, we're gonna talk about the channel of the week. And these guys, it's a husband and wife, Stuart Carroll and Alina Carroll. They run a website called Drone Film Guide, I believe. Anyway, I link to the channel here, link to their website below. I just found these guys and they are both great teachers. I think he's a filmmaker and he does a lot of wedding stuff, but recently he's been incorporating some teaching into his channel, and I like his style, like his accent. They're both from Scotland. And again, he's a great artist, as you'll see if you peruse some of his videos, has some great content, but I've been learning a lot about drone flying and coming up with some different artistic styles, color grading, all of that kind of stuff from his channel. So definitely recommend those guys for this week's channel of the week. And as always, more on all of this later.